you might be thinking really carefully about how can I lead my students? How can I be the adult that they need right now and support their well-being? But we cannot do that if we don't first look after ourselves. And there is a big issue right now, and if you're feeling it, you're so far from alone. Everyone's going to be feeling the same thing. There's a big issue with imposter syndrome. So that feeling that we all get always after the long summer holiday of, I think I've completely forgotten how to do my job. It's been a while, can I still do this? I don't know, that's really normal. But actually it's amplified right now because not only have we been away a while, but the parameters have changed and what our job fundamentally looks like is kind of different. And we haven't been able to do all the normal preparation that we might have done, and just things are a bit challenging. You're not alone in it. You're completely together with everyone else. And that's an important thing to acknowledge first. So please be honest and authentic in that and in your struggles with your peers, because that will help and it will make you realize that we're all in this together. But the other thing here is to have a think about how can you use this, how you're managing the uncertainty and how you're facing the challenge of returning to support your students. Because you've got two options here. One is to be the hero and to put on the mask and to look like you're sailing through every day perfectly, and for some of us maybe that's the way that we want to approach it, and that's okay. But the other approach here is to wear our hearts on our sleeves a little bit more and to be a bit more open and honest and vulnerable and authentic with our learners and say, hey, I found some bits of this quite hard too. I was a bit nervous about coming back to school. I've been struggling with the uncertainty and not really knowing what's going to happen next. And being a little bit honest about that and talking about the different things that we might be doing in order to help ourselves and how we're managing those feelings of uncertainty. One of the really helpful things I find to think about here is, what are the things I can control? What are the things within my locus of control? And what are the things that are beyond my locus of control? And how can I learn to live with those things? This is helpful for us, and it's helpful for our students too. Imposter syndrome is perfectly normal, really common, and it's massive right now. The other thing that this situation has done has meant that we are all learning together and hierarchy is somewhat out of the window. Our senior leaders and our very new staff are all facing this experience for the first time. And so, if we can be brave enough and bold enough to challenge ourselves in our learning together, we can very much learn together. So seek advice from each other, seek support from each other, be honest in your struggles, but also share what you find is working. We all need to learn, we all need to face this challenge together, and there will be good and quicker ways forwards if we put our heads together. Multiple heads is always better than one. And again, remember, sometimes just enabling someone else to feel a little bit less alone in their struggle and with their challenges can mean that that feels more manageable, more doable, more safe. So if you or a colleague are particularly struggling, or perhaps you have struggled with a loss or a separation during this time, actually making yourself or your colleague less alone in that, walking alongside, is really important and supportive thing to do, even if you can't change the situation.